Tataraakina team. Righty, righty. Adventure on, mission on. It is a Friday afternoon. I've got the day off and I've got a booking to go back up home to Tataraakina and hunt for the weekend. So, the original plan was to go pick up the other brother, Jason Corkle, who was last with me in Tataraakina for a hunt. He gave me a bell last night. He wasn't feeling so flash. I think it's COVID. Woke up this morning. He'd been hallucinating all night long. He's pretty effed up. So unfortunately, he won't be coming, but I'm gonna go grab his four-wheeler bike anyway, because we need it for access into the block. And I've gone to the bench and picked up another Jay, and his name is Jay Pormana, probably a relation of mine. He's hunted in this block before with other family members, so he's coming off the bench. He's gonna take Jay Corkle's place for this weekend. So stand by, I'm gonna head to Levin, go pick up the four-wheel bike off the sick brother, and then mission on, decoy on.
Time flies like the spark in your eyes when you're taking it day by day.
Alrighty, we're in the Art Deco capital of New Zealand, in the mighty Napier, my hometown. Very sunny, very warm. Just got to go pick up the key, pop around to catch up with the Tightlines team, and then hop in, see the old man, game on.
You give and you take, you love and you chase. That's all she wrote. You laugh and you cry, you live and you die. That's all she wrote.
I'm just living my life. I'm just living my life. I'm just living my life. I'm just living my life.
It'll be well. First trip for the Outlander, and it did a good job. Let's go have a look at the river. It's 20 degrees here in the mighty Hawke's Bay, and it's what, 1:45? We're thinking maybe we go for, oh my goodness, a fly fish, a fish first, and then go for a hunt. Have a look at the water. Oh my goodness, crystal clear, crystal clear. Oh, there's got to be a fish in there, got to be a fish in there. I can't stop looking at the water. Anyway, I'll catch up with Jay, make a plan. Fly fishing mode, round two down this river, hit up the Mokomoko Nui, a bit of a nosy, see how we get on. Here we go, bro. Nice Mokomoko Nui rainbow. Hooked the dry fly, pretty deadly too. Now we're just gonna chuck him back, catch his mate that's in there. 4 o'clock, done with our fishing. Now we're going to...
Up the top,
where?
Here.
Jay's gonna take his ute in. I'll take the bike in nice and clean. See how far we get up to the top, and if he can't take his ute any far, we'll jump on the bike. So we're away. Here we go. So we have arrived at our camping spot. We're gonna walk right up the top of there. Oh, actually way over there. Get onto a nice saddle. Honestly, we've seen probably about 50 goats coming in, a big, probably about a 4-point stag and a hind, all on the track. You all good, bro?
Sweet as, brother.
We're away. So, just before we trot off,
we'll do a weapons safety status. Jay's up the front, he's running point. So what's the status of your rifle, bro?
Rounds are in the internal mag.
Yeah.
Nothing up the spout.
Yeah, all right. And he'll close the action. Yeah, just in case he sees one on the track.
Which we already have.
Yeah. So I'm running number two. Oh, everything, mine's all strapped there. No mag on, bolt in, no rounds in the chamber. Alrighty. Let's get up to the posse. Anyway, so we've spotted our first group of deer. They're about 600 metres off and they're up on that knob up there. So we've still got a bit of a way to push through here. We might be able to push out onto that other knob and get a shot. We'll just see how we go. But we've got to obviously stalk in now, so yeah, we'll see how we get on. But that's good to see the deer over.
Fucking hell, bro.
Yeah, you know, well, there could be some out here, you never know. So we just got to take our time, be careful. Here we go.
So as we made our way up the track, we dropped into our first basin and spotted two Jap spikers. Jay quickly stepped up, got into position, squeezed off the shot. The old 280 jammed up. The old deer had been clipped in the back of the lung and was still standing around. With Jay's jammed rifle, there was only one thing left to do. Strip the savage off the side of my pack. Find the ammo, screw the suppressor on, and finish off the deer.
Well, we got one.
It didn't take long.
Fucking bit of calamity.
Anyway.
But, Jay clipped it, then the old 280 jammed. So I unleashed the savage. The deer's just over there. But, we didn't even make it halfway to those other deer, but I'm just going to pop back down the track and see if we can see those other deer. And if they're there, we're going to get up to that knob and have a crack at them. Weapon safety. I've no mag on. Going to fire the action. What are you, bro?
Nothing in the chamber.
You would have spent case in there.
Man.
Well, that's a big fat negatory. They're gone, so we'll deal with this one and then set up on the blind for the evening. Oh, we're off to a good start anyway, so cool.
Now the pipe providers, keep the mouth. Cool little knives, aren't they?
Okay. Hmm. He likes the helium, Herbie. Like the helium. Deadly. I don't think I'm going to get my hands bloody.
Now that's apprentice's job.
So what's going to happen now is we're going to leave this deer hanging, and it's like middle of summer and the blowflies are humming, but the bro saw this trick. What's the trick, bro?
Brother from Ngati Kai Providers.
Yep.
Yeah, stuffs the manuka.
Manuka into the webo?
Into the body.
Into the body. To stop the
See? Flies can't get in there now, cuz.
Well, there's a shout out for you.
Kai mo te tepu.
Kai mo te tepu. Oh, did Trav tell you?
Travis.
Bro, Trav. I didn't realise that was Trav's tip.
Sorry, my cuz. I was trying to remember his name, but I'm too busy down the main. Sorry, my brother. Nah, that's all good, mate.
Brother Trav, he's hearty. Anyway, we's on the board, get this deer sussed out, and then recon up a new spot for tomorrow morning shot, so pretty cool. And this is not making a very good video at all, but that's number two down. Hell savage, I just zapped a hind, was just sitting in here, and I tried to lay down with the pack on and it smashed me in the head and pushed me down and I couldn't see the scope, and then it spooked up and then ran just up that little track there. I'll give it a whistle out, and Japs don't normally respond to whistles, but she stopped and she's been poleaxed.
Beautiful, brother.
Yeah, ended up being a little boy, young old pubescent spiker, first year of spikes, or last year actually. But yeah, I made a dirty bitty hole. I don't want to show you because you might lose your dinner. But no, let's get this one tidied up, and then Jay and I are just going to go sit back up on that ridge and glass for the evening, and then probably amble back and take our deer back. So.
Yeah, the white rocks. Seen the.
So, what happened? We saw another deer, had a crack at it and missed right. The wind was pumping, just a silly wind hold, or lack of a wind hold. Saw pigs, goats, didn't get shots off, it's just gotten too dark. So our plan is to bone all our deer out and mosey on back to camp. But, didn't really show you guys that, but that's our deer was hanging up there, and I've just put all the legs, all the back stakes on my meat shelf just under here. So my meat shelf's got all the legs on it. I've got back stakes in the back of the pack, and there's my 30 liter day pack on the back of there. So not a bad little system actually. Anyway, you all good, bro? All right. That's us. We're away. Bright and early and warm as anything. There was a real warm sleep last night, real warm sleep. Our meat hasn't quite set on the hook. I'll show you. Still a bit pliable and tacky. Hasn't really gone hard like we wanted it to. We're gonna have to cover that all up. Get our camp squared away and make a plan to head on up, or we might try and take the bike a little bit further this morning just to cut that hill out, and then make our way quietly up to the shooting blind, so in the darkness, under the cover of darkness. So, bit of breakfast and we're up. Social media.
Well, we spotted our first deer for the morning. It's way, way down there. Actually, just there. It's way, way too far away. Probably getting out of this bloody wind, so it's good to see them. Really good to see them. Oh, nice mob of three deer way down there. Same place we've been spotting them this morning. Plenty of animals out, but just bloody out of range at the moment. So we'll keep glassing. So Jay snuck up here. Well, there it is.
Thank you, brother.
All good. That was massive.
Well, that's our day over for deer hunting.
Mahi time.
Mahi time. We'll go down and recover him and get the flock out of here. Go get our stuff and go fly fishing.
Yes.
Right, let's go. There he is, my hearty brother. One of the OGs and clearly a good set of eyeballs. Look at that. Look at that hole, man. And it ran off when he just had to cut its throat. So, and it's here. We're about 100 meters off the top. What the fuck?
Oh, we're ending the miss again.
Oh, man. Oh, we'll clean this one out. It's a red, this one. This one's a red deer. We shot Sika.
Yep.
Sika yesterday. Got a nice red today. So, we'll... start boning out. Well, get some photos for the Instagram first. Righty, so that's that. Deer recovered. We're just going to load it up into packs. Into the pack. I just got to do a couple of shout outs for some of the people that sponsor me and some of my gear providers. My first shout out's got to go to my Australian guys that follow me. This guy here, Bush Edge. This is their chess rig. Obviously it's actually a twin needle one, but for your Australian guys, Mark's got a whole heap of these over there, and obviously you might need to get some of these accessory pouches, and obviously you can get all these sort of things to Velcro on. They're pretty deadly, man. Obviously good old New Zealand made, but Bush Edge over in Australia have these if you guys need to get them just in Australia. So he's got a whole heap of other gear on his website as well, so go check out Bush Edge. Okay, so my next little shout out goes to I'll probably need to explain a little bit about this rifle. So this rifle is a project rifle that I'm working with an importer company. So this is obviously the Savage Ultralight for 1110, looking at getting into this ultralight stuff. I've got the Zerotech scope on it. I have got the Backlands carbon fiber bipod on it. So it's really the ultralight package for climbing around the mountains, and a little humping I had to do just now worked out just perfect. On top here, I'll screw it off because I don't really want to point a rifle at anybody. On here, I have the DPT Magnum suppressor wrapped in the Weka
Weka Stealth silicone cover. Got to do a shout out to Darren Toms for supplying the DPT suppressor for this little project. I know from a lot of the guys that follow me and the brothers of Boo Boo, the DPT suppressors, engineering and quality and the follow-up workmanship is absolutely bang on. So that's pretty much us. We're gonna pack up and YY Express back up that hill and go across some more hills, pick up our other gear, walk back to camp, have some breakfast and go. Bye. So that's our camp all packed up and all those goats on the road. Just sent Jay ahead so that he's got an old 303. He's gonna try and knock a few goats over just to help with the pest control. So hopefully we'll hear a few bang, bang, bangs in a minute. Well, looks like our hunting and fishing luck has run out for the weekend. Pools like this, fished it like a ninja, and then came up to the pool, had a good look in, nothing moved. So, I don't know where they've gone, or someone's been up here early this morning and tagged the whole out, or I'm just useless. The fish aren't there, well, the fish aren't there. Clearly not that Jay and I could see anyway. So make our way back to the car and then we'll do our outro. Well, there it is. That was a pretty cool mission back to my home block of Tataraakina up in the mighty Hawke's Bay. Pretty cool for my bro to come along. Jay Pulmana, the heartiest of hearty bobs. What were the highlights, bro, for you?
Being allowed here.
Being allowed here, right?
Yeah. Oh, bro, everything. The good luck.
Yep.
The epic good luck. Those fish, the deer, that was a crack up. Like, we shoot one deer and we think, oh no, we're going to go way up there, 100 meters or something. We get another one. Finding this morning stag was cool because, I was honestly wasn't too keen to shoot him, but nah.
It was more like he didn't want to go retrieve him. But we definitely nailed a few animals and the car's loaded with venison. I've got to try and get it back and get some ice around it. But it was really good to have you on this trip, my bro. Thank you very much.
Much love, brother. Thank you.
Anyway, have you got any shout-outs, by the way? Any shout-outs to any of the brothers or anyone you want to?
Jason Corkle, much love, brother. Thank you for the kite. Appreciate the opportunity. Cheers, my bro.
Oh, and thanks for having the COVID-19 and can't come so he could come. Anyway, that's not that funny, is it?
No. But we love you anyway.
Yeah, mate. Right. Yeah, mate. Yeah. Anyway, I really do hope you guys enjoyed that video. It wasn't a lot of my classic long-range shooting, but it was more old-style sort of a bit of walk and stalk and jump down and shoot the deer. So, like I said, hope you enjoyed it. Like and subscribe, and we'll catch you on the next one.